Hey folks, how's it going this morning?
Alright, good, good. I'm just gonna turn up my volume a little bit. Today we're gonna be playing a very interesting looking game called Scanner Somber. I've opted to not have my webcam on for this one, because it is a very visual game, as are all games, video games, almost all of them. But I wanted to give the screen all the real estate on this one. So, doing the rare thing of not having a webcam this time. Hope you all enjoy. All right, let's do this. Alright, so we're in a tent. Family. Alright, so you can zoom with your right clicker. It must be me. I'm Mom. I guess. I mean, I could be one of the kids. I'm gonna assume I'm Mom. For now. Well, alright. I guess this is one you could play with VR. Awesome. I should probably do that at some point. Prototype installed. Scanner. Hold the left mouse to fire the scanner. And this is how we're gonna find our way. Ah, so we're in a cave. Stalactites. Those would be stalagmites. Stalactites hang from the ceiling. Anything else over here? Or just at the very beginning of the cave? Yeah. There's some stalactites. Hey, Sly Guy. Welcome. I think I'm actually gonna... Since I'm not using my webcam, I'm gonna turn my lights off. I think this is a game that would benefit from very little light. I know. That's not Tony Hawk. Hey, Gabriella. Yeah. Yeah, I'd love to try this in VR. It looks like it was built for it. Nobody had been as deep as this for thousands of years. I'm in the mood to play some independent games. I was utterly alone. No call for help would ever reach the surface. My friends all told me I was crazy. My wife couldn't understand my obsession. Oh, okay, so I guess we're the husband. But I had to know if the myths were true. I thought we were the mom, but I guess we're the dad. It's just his family picture he had in his tent. It's cool how you can see, like, parts of the cave you've explored just through all that. So we're in a cave, and we have this scanning device that, yeah, it lights up with little kind of pinprick scan lasers. And, like, our character is wearing, like, a VR kind of headset, so he can see these little radio, these little laser scans. I mean, your guess is as good as mine. We just woke up in a tent with a picture of our family, and we're in a cave. So it sounds like we're, like the dad of the family, and we just have this like obsession with this cave. That's about all we know. It's like my family didn't understand why I wanted to go, but I went anyway. Oh, hello. Total stations, it looks like. Something like that. Ah, bridge. These look like the total stations that you survey geological, geographical information with. Aperture control. Use the mouse wheel to change the aperture. Oh, I can... Neat. I can widen it, or I can shorten it. Could this place... Could this place have been even older than the legend suggested? The resolution was astonishing. Never before had such a powerful geological scanner been available. I think the different colors just represent how close you are. So the redder it is, the closer you are to it. The bluer it is, the farther away. Like this red area is gonna eventually turn blue as you move away from it. Let's see the gap in the bridge. Never been spelunking. This would be a neat way to do it, though. Oh, hello. The heck? Huh. Well, okay then. That's a tight squeeze. Ah, that looks like some kind of... These look like pillars. Ah, I'm a little stuck. There we go. Yeah, this looks like a man-made entryway to something. I don't think it's necessarily horror. I mean, it has unknown elements to it, so that's like naturally unnerving, but I think it's supposed to just be kind of one, like, be full of wonder. See, I'm thinking now that this structure, like, that's actually like a statue for whatever ancient society was down here. I don't think it's an actual human body. There's a cave. But yeah, of course, if you were in this situation and you saw that, of course the first thing you're gonna think is, it's a human. And you see all these pillars standing around it. It looks like a pedestal for some kind of statue. a neat kind of exploration game. Like Gone Home, like it had some chilling like scenery to it, but it turned out to be just very beautiful by the end of it, which really kind of helped with the idea of like going home to a house you haven't been in a long time, turning on the lights one by one. It does feel unnerving, but eventually that feeling of like I'm home, I'm in a safe place washes over you. Okay, down here I guess. Press R and B or Z to zoom. All right, right mouse button or Z. Gotcha. This looks like a building, maybe, or maybe just another bridge. Okay, so several bridges. Aperture, get a little bit more space. Alright. Well, guess we're not going over that part of the bridge. The ground's still there. I just haven't scanned it. Huh. We got a staircase here that leads to nothing, really. Be a cave-in at some point. Beautiful. Okay. Can't cross this yet. It's all broken. And it's not bottomless. You can see a floor. I still wouldn't want to drop down there, though. That could hurt. Alright. Well, this is the only area I think we can go in. Well, maybe we can go over here. Nah, it's blocked as well. So there's gotta be... Oh, okay, I see. There's some stairs leading up. It's interesting, because, like, where are they leading from? Yeah, so my guess is that it was a cave-in. These toppled pillars. Yeah, you can kind of see rocks, pillar, caved in at some point. Okay, guess we're dropping down. Okay, so I can jump a little bit further than I thought. Let's go back to where we were. Well, oh, this works. Oh my god. Okay, maybe it is a little horrifying. That's not a statue. Playing this in the dark. Uh-oh. I fell. Oh. Well, gotta reactivate that horror show. Alright. Do-do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Just a moment. All right. Hello. Makes me think of the Weeping Angels from Doctor Who. Oh, it's gone now. Uh-oh. Well. They never did iron out all the glitches. Uh-huh, that's what it is. Yeah, I know, where's the human? Here's the thing. Sometimes you'd see a sensor, see sensor echoes from days earlier. Calibrations turned to ghost. Yeah, keep believing that. But even so, I never could explain everything I saw. Well, he's talking in past tense. Like this already happened. Can I read the chat? I've got a second monitor. I look at the chat. A crevasse. There's another upgrade for our scanner. And that's how to get it over there. But how do we get over there? Too narrow. Can I jump across this? Is that what I'm gonna have to do? Leap of faith, this. I might have to, yeah. Oh, I'm not. Yeah, I'm not playing it in VR. Though it would be a good VR game. It seems to be made for that.
Whoa!
Okay. None of that then. Why is the camera down? What are you talking about? Hold on. Don't know what you mean. Oh, the webcam. Sorry. Oh, yeah. I just wanted this game to not have my face on it because it's. It's very explorative. Alright, just a moment. Minimize my thing. There we go. Okay, now. Let's go back. Maybe there's another way around. Something. Oh, just came back around. Sidle. I don't know if I'm gonna make it all the way though. Is this really what I'm supposed to do? Oh, I think so. What the what? image of someone falling off. Creepy. Oh my gosh. Ooh. Two people. Yeah, I guess it is kind of a horror game. Something supernatural happening. Our narrator explains it as a glitch in the scanner technology, like seeing echoes of something. Is a human. Don't know if it was the same statue-y one or not. Sidle along the wall again. Get to that other piece of the scanner. Surprised that this was actually what they wanted me to do. Just kind of squeeze up against the wall. Burst scan. Press B to initiate burst scan. Neat! There we go. That's helpful. Alright, it takes a little while to charge. You can see it in the bottom. Bottom left. Where is this? I don't know. Some cave. A cave. Alright, well, I guess we're going down. Slidey. Thank you. Slidey. Pretty. Scanner. Whoa. That's a big rock face. Okay. Well, I guess I'm jumping. Yeah, it is pretty. Scanner sombrero. Thought it was gonna be some robot luchador thing. Maybe a should play Guacamelee. Like we're in some more man-made halls. Oh. The temple must have been over 1,000 years old. I knew they existed. I'd searched for the cultists all my life. Ooh. But to finally see it in person, to be the first. That's what I was thinking of. My friend streamed it a way back. I still haven't played it. And I like Metroidvanias, but I haven't played Guacamelee yet. Yeah. Very pretty. Pretty. All right, have a good one. Another one of these statues, but it's fallen over. This is where they perform the sacrifices. The more I scanned around the altar, the more it revealed. Another upgrade. Hello. Oh no. Guess they jumped. Map view. Press M to view your map. Neato. Prisons. I guess we're going to the prisons. I always wondered how many poor bastards they threw over the edge. I don't know if the person on the pedestal was a sacrifice. It seemed like it was kind of like a welcoming thing almost. The way it had its arms all stretched out. Welcoming or a warning. I guess it could be both depending on who you are. Either. The cultists believed the cave itself was malevolent, that the dead could never escape. Their victims were doomed to relive their final tortured hours forever. No wonder people went mad down here. Oh, we're in the prison. See the... Yep. I can't get up that way. Now, here we go. This one. Yeah, I guess it is. Alright, now we're on the other side of these prison bars. Squeeze. Huh. More trees. The cultists slept and ate here. Like the monks who came after. They spent their time in silent prayer to an unanswering God. Dead end. chest.
Treasure.
Can't have it. Another one of these statues. Yeah, bed chambers. There we go, I think. Yeah. It's like spray painting with lasers. Sprayzers. Hey, Bat, welcome. Welcome. Yeah. Yep. It's very pretty. And also unnerving. We're in a cave, and our character's wearing like this VR kinda headset. And his scanning technology is allowing him to see like the little pinpricks of light that hit the surfaces. Apparently there used to be we're in the water. Used to be a group of cultists who lived down here, and we just went through their whole area. Guess I don't want to go in the water. It starts messing with my tech. I've seen some weird stuff. That's water. Cool. I like how it is reflective like that. That's pretty. It's pretty. Gotta go through there. So no standing while I'm in the water. Interesting. Gotta wait for it to dry off too. There we go. So that's a mechanic I'm sure we'll see repeat at some point, where we're having to make our way through with water without the use of our scanner. The witch trials came much later. The witch trials came much later. So that's what these cages were for. They used to drag witches down here and purge them in huge numbers. Evil throughout the ages. Jeez. There's no doubt they believed in the myths. It was no accident they chose this cave. They wanted to imprison the evil down here as eternal punishment. Hmm. What the what? No! Ew. Creepy. Well, I wonder if they just reappear when I get in the water. Yeah, they do. I guess I don't want to stay in the water, though. God dang it. They don't like me being in their water. Fine. It's some... Yeah. It seems to have some horror elements in it. Though nothing's, like, tried to hurt us yet. We've just seen some things that are kind of scary. It's more like we're disturbing something that's... tortured. Yeah, right? Scary screams. There's a cave, good. Yeah, I wonder if I would get hurt if I touched those bodies. I did wonder if it was true, of course. No way these were just glitches. If the souls who died down here never get to leave. That much death occurring in such a confined space. What horrors must they have seen in their final moments? Wonder what happens if I touch one of them. Let's not find out. We can help it. It makes it that much more scary if we try to avoid. Ah, there's another upgrade for our scanner. Oh, more water. Right? Who's Norman the projectionist? Don't see immediately another way around. Yeah, water everywhere. But not a drop to drink. Here we go. We're just gonna wade through the awful sounds. I think we're gonna die. Okay, so they do hurt you. From Bendy. I did wonder if it was true, of course. No way, these are just glitches. Alright, so definitely stay out of the water then. Alright, so that's the first thing that's killed us. That much. Yeah, we already read this. We gotta find a path across, not just go through the water. Yeah. Scary. But yeah, horror. Water. Okay, don't see another way from this spot. Maybe. Well, there's land. Well, looks like I might have to jump in. Get over there. There we go. It's like an old Windows computer background. How's it going, Binary Echo? There's our next scanner mod. Sensor upgrade. The scanner resolution has been increased. Awesome. More powerful. Very good. Welcome back, dork. So apparently those things that come out of the water, they can kill you. So don't stay in the water too long. Oh boy. Souls of the dead. Yeah, we just went through a whole area with a lot of water. Your scanner stops working when you're wading through it. Like, here's some. See how the laser points disappear in it? This water seems safe. But yeah, you can kind of see the glitching happening when you're in it. If it's wide enough, your scanner stops working in it. It takes a second to dry off. Oh, boat. Oh, boy. Can I boat? No? Okay. I want to boat. Watched Jacob Geller's video essay on games with like bad graphics and like just him pointing out some that are just amazing, and this was one of them. More water. Few others that I want to play on stream as well from that list. Come on. Load up. Thank you.
Fascinating.
Can see like the reflection of the ceiling and in the water. Love it. What was that? Probably nothing good. Look at our mappy. A little island here. I don't know where I need to be. Probably need to go this way. Yeah, there are sounds. Catch you off guard. Meant to unnerve you. Caves are alive. Circulatory system. They grow. Like it anyway. Maybe I can get up here. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah. Your doggos went nuts when they heard it. Yeah. Trying to figure out where I need to go next. Maybe this way. Is that the way we came? I don't know. Try this one. Dead end. More cages. Yeah, what I've already scanned is on the map. Gotta be this way. Might just have to jump in. All right. Little bit of time before they can reach me, but not too long. I don't think I can stand for more than like 10 seconds. Yeah. This presumably one of the witches they drowned. Or one of the people they called witches. Pretty narrow. Can't get up there either. All right. Might have to go through this water. Some of this already. I'm not sure though. I'd be going in a big circle. Okay, well, I guess I'm going to head back to the sensor upgrade. Yeah, I think that's probably where I need to go. However, what's the best way to get there? Among the sleep. Mm-hmm. Water, water. Lots of it. Don't know if there's gonna be an easy way around here. Dead end. Okay. Well, definitely gonna have to go through some water then. Purging cages. Those are right over there, I guess. Good. I guess I don't have to go through water. I can just drop over here. Yeah, good. Good, good. Yeah, I think I'm going. Yeah, I'm going the right way. I guess I'm gonna head to that lake. Looked like it was called Lake Evil. Dead end. We'll have to. I guess I can jump. Yeah, nice. Oh, we're getting there. Over that way. Nice. Like exit, that's what it was. Okay. So yeah, where this boat is, I thought I couldn't use it, but it looks like maybe we do have to use it. Booty! Well, baddies aren't messing with me here. Oh, so I can use it. Okay. I just have to point in the direction and like press up on my just press forward and I can use the boat. All right. Oh well, we get to explore more cave. That was good. There's no earthly way of knowing which direction we are rowing. Is it raining? Is it snowing? Is a hurricane a-blowing? Huh. The smoke of the head is showing, so the danger must be growing. Pretty. Cool. Yeah, very beautiful. Beautiful. Looks like there's the dock. Thank you, boat. Another scanner. Mod. Yo, I see ya. Yeah, please don't hit me with that pick. Material scanner. Press tab to switch sensor mode. Huh. So many have died down here. Looks like we found a mine shaft. The miners that came for work, they were just as superstitious. They were terrified of this place. All those that lost their lives to negligence, are they trapped down here too? Color variation now with different things. Oh, people fell. Yep, they gave us a nice little reprieve on the lake. But now we're back into the horror part of the game. Back into the guts. We traveled into the heart. Now we're back in the guts. Broken railing. Yep. This part of the bridge gave out. Or the rock base. And that's where they all fell from. I think. Some of them. Some scanners. Legit forgot it was a horror game for a second. Good job on them. Ow. Whoops. I fell. What happened to you guys? Okay, cave in? Can't tell. Or were you fighting? I don't know. Did the cave drive you mad? There's a path. Good. Stairs. Does it matter that all of this is my memory? Does it make it any less real? I was there. I was the first. Souls. Interesting. Kind of left a shadow because I hit him from this side, but it didn't hit the wall. Neat. What do we have here? I remember coming down like it was yesterday. Hoping I'd find something below. Hoping it wouldn't be another empty cave. I just wish I'd been better prepared. can probably jump down there. Yeah, I think I'm meant to. Yes, but how do I get over there? Don't know. Guess I gotta follow the blue. How do I get back up there? That's where we came down. Alright, so we can't get back up that way. To go around the long way. Or something. Alright, good. This is the prettiest horror game I've ever seen or heard. How many times do I have to relive this? Always the same rock, the same metal, the same stale air. And the guilt. I want to see my family again. I don't know how I died. Of all the memories I'm forced to relive, it's the one thing I don't remember. It breaks my heart knowing I left my family behind. They're always here for me. Family. They know I'm never coming back.
Thank you.
start you right back in the starting in your tent. Just with all the things you've explored. Oh, interesting. Yep. It all gets wiped away. You're made to relive it again. Oh. Yeah, it was a cutscene. Somber. A nice, pretty, and unsettling game. Makes me think of, like Dear Esther and, Gone Home. Yeah. Well, alrighty. Well, that was that. Hope you guys enjoyed. That was fun to play, for sure. I appreciate these, like, just very, very original kind of game. Neato. Let's see. I guess I'll put on my webcam. There we go. There me am. So yeah, that was a fun one. I have several more I want to play, but we're already at 12:30 today. So yeah, I think that's gonna be it for today's session. Thank you all again for hanging out and watching. I appreciate it. I had a lot of fun with this one. Yeah, I exist. I'm here. let's see. I think next on my list. Let's see. Yeah, maybe Off Peak City. It's like very abstract. So I might play that next. But yeah. All right. Till next time, I'll see y'all later. All right. Bye-bye.